Hey Toasters, here we are on Thursday, and today's game we are toasting is Sonic Colors for the DS. Now, Sonic Colors for the DS is a very, very different game than the Wii version. And in a way, I feel like it's more so part three of the Sonic Rush series, to tell you the truth, because it feels like it. I mean, you know what the Sonic Rush games are like, or at least you should. You know, you run fast, you're boosting, you're jumping over stuff and crazy bears, and that's what this is. And one thing is, it's got, of course, the Wisp power-ups, which a lot of them I feel like work better in this game than they do in the Wii one. The Wisp power-ups are weird in the 3D setting, but in this one, flat 2D plane, piece of cake, laser, fire. Oh, this one's got the fire wisp. The fire wisp isn't even in the Wii one. The fire wisp is pretty cool. You just charge up and shoot yourself off like a fireball. Crazy. I just farted as I said that. Anyway, toast. You know what's not super great about this game? I mean, the standard levels are pretty good. The bonus levels, just fine. That's always a key in a Sonic game. When there's bad bonus levels, that can just ruin the whole experience for you sometimes. But this game has these extra missions where, like, you meet Cream the Rabbit. She says, oh, go do this mission as fast as you can in this time limit. Okay. And it's hard. It's really hard. You meet Blaze the Cat. Blaze says, oh, Sonic, Zebra, Zebra, Hippo, do this really fast in this time limit and get these checkpoints. Really, Blaze? Do I really have to? We're supposed to be saving these aliens. Oh, look, there's Silver the Hedgehog. Hey, Silver, you want to help with this mission? No, Sonic, I want you to go and kill this many enemies. Why do I have to go through and break the rule? Just do it! All these extra missions that are really, really hard, and you don't feel like you complete the game unless you do these extra missions. But they're really hard and really time-consuming, so that kind of kills it for me. But besides that, if you can bring yourself to ignore all those extra characters, then it's an excellent game. It's a lot of fun. Good 2D platforming. Just I'd say it's almost as good as Sonic Rush. I don't know. It's a good game. It's a good game, leave it at that. And it's cool that you do tie in all those other Sonic characters. I mean, like, Team Dark is in this game. Of course, Amy, Cream. I don't recall seeing Big. Is Big in this game? I don't think Big is. But Knuckles is. That's important. And there's a gag in here, because you know how Omega wants to be, like, the superior robot. That's why he's always killing all the other robots. He meets Orbot and Cubot, and he's like, prepare to be destroyed. And they're like, ah! So that's funny. So yeah. Sonic Colors for the DS. It's a decent, pretty decent Sonic game, a fun venture for your handheld. So, thanks for watching Daily Toast. Tune in tomorrow, Friday, for our last Daily Toast of the week.